According to Elon Musk, nobody expects the Cybertruck. On November 21st, Elon Musk unveiled the Cybertruck to the world. First off, I'm sure you've seen this thing. It doesn't look like anything else I've ever seen. And so let's start there with the design. This design is loved by a lot of people and hated by a lot of people. See, while I think it's kind of ugly, I also think that this design lends itself to looking very rugged and utilitarian, which is something you want in a truck. And for that reason, I think a lot of people are actually drawn to the ugliness. I am interested to see how the production version comes out. What are the colors they're going to offer it in? What kind of wheels? I think these things will make a big difference and make the thing look a lot better. Looking at the design from a practicality standpoint, it makes sense on a couple levels. First is that triangular shape that kind of hides the bed at the back. That actually makes the truck a lot more streamlined. The air can move up over the cab and then smoothly down over the back deck. And that will reduce drag, which gives the truck improved range. Secondly, with all those flat panels, I feel like repair work could actually be improved. You could theoretically just cut out a panel, weld in a new panel, and given the look of the thing, it would match up pretty easily. This also is important because that frame is a structural component. As Elon said in the presentation, they use 30 times cold rolled stainless steel, which is similar to that this SpaceX is using on the Starship that they're building. It's a very heavyweight metal. And so the actual frame of the vehicle is the body of the vehicle. I believe this is even more so than the unibody construction that most automakers are using on vehicles nowadays. It definitely is super strong because, as demonstrated in the presentation, Franz took a sledgehammer to it and it didn't even dent, unlike the traditional truck door that he tried. The advantages of moving the frame to the outside of the vehicle are that you would get more usable space in the vehicle. And it should also stiffen the entire frame. There are a couple disadvantages I'd be worried about. One is that in the event of an accident, if you damage one part of the frame, will you have to replace the entire vehicle? The other question I have regards crumple zones, and with a really tough shell, how will that affect occupancy safety in the event of an accident? I'm sure this is something they'll address. Teslas tend to be some of the safest cars on the road. And so I don't expect that to be an issue. The other super tough material that was demoed was the glass. This is a bullet-resistant, ballistic, armored glass, as Tesla calls it. It'd be similar to what they use on the windshield of their upcoming semi-truck. During the presentation, some cyberpunk-looking individuals, who I imagine are engineers, dropped some steel balls at varying heights onto a sheet of this glass, and it did not break. When Franz, the chief designer, took the same ball and chucked it at the window of the actual truck, it broke. And so he tried it again and that window broke. Now, in all fairness, Elon put out a video after the fact of Franz throwing the ball at the window before the event and it just bounced off. So whatever was going on during the event was really unfortunate, and the press has kind of made a big deal out of this. I don't think it's a big deal. As Elon said, it's room for improvement. So the truck is tough, and Elon even poked a little jab at Ford in that department.
You want a truck that's really tough, not fake tough?
But how does it stand up on the other specs? Well, as we would expect, this is an electric vehicle, and so your performance off the line, your torque and your power is extremely high relative to a gas vehicle. In its fastest variant, the Cybertruck should achieve a 0 to 60 time of 2.9 seconds and a top speed of 130 miles per hour. So it's no slouch in the performance department, and they even showed a video of it racing and defeating a Porsche 911. So how does this truck stack up against other EV trucks that are coming out in the next couple of years? I compared the Cybertruck to the Rivian RT1, the Bollinger B2, which was announced a few months ago, and then the Atlis XT truck, which has not been demoed, but they have some designs in the works, so I included it for completeness. The first item on the list is price, and in this department, the Cybertruck really excels, starting at $39,900 and going right up to just under $70,000. The Rivian starts at about $70,000, the Bollinger at about $125,000, and the Atlis XT is estimated at $45,000. Looking at 0 to 60 times, the Cybertruck varies between 6.5 and 2.9. The Rivian 4.9 to 3 seconds, the Bollinger is at 4.5 seconds, and the Atlis XT is around 5 seconds. Top speed, the Cybertruck has everything else beat at 130 miles per hour. The Cybertruck varies between 250 and 500 miles of range, which is really something we haven't seen from Tesla, with the exception of the upcoming Roadster at 600 miles of range. This compares favorably with the Rivian at 400 miles of range and the Atlas truck, which should be able to go up to 500 miles. Looking at power and torque, Tesla does not give official numbers, but Motor Trend has estimated the power could be as high as 800 horsepower and the torque could be up to 1,000 foot-pounds. This far exceeds what's available from Rivian as well as Bollinger. On the payload side, the Cybertruck can haul more weight than the Rivian, not quite as much as the Bollinger, and it fits right in the range of the Atlas XT. For bed length, the Cybertruck has a 6.5-foot bed, which is better than the Rivian and better than the Bollinger. Towing capacity is very good. It exceeds the Rivian as well as the Bollinger. The Atlas XT may be able to haul more, but that's in a fifth wheel gooseneck configuration. This truck has a lot of ground clearance at 16 inches. The Bollinger will go up to 20, but they're pretty much in the same ballpark. The Cybertruck can come with 1, 2, or 3 motors, which is slightly less than you see from Rivian and Atlas. Rivian and Atlas are really going for a 4-motor, 4-wheel system, whereas the Tesla uses more of their traditional drivetrain that you would find in their other vehicles. On the availability side, the Cybertruck is running a little bit behind the competitors, with the first production models looking to come out somewhere in the 2021 to 2022 timeframe. This timeframe was a little disappointing, but I imagine with all the vehicles Tesla has in the pipeline and all the things they're working on, they really had to focus their efforts on the Model Y, the semi-truck, as well as maybe the Roadster that's coming out. While it's interesting to compare the Cybertruck with other EVs, how does it stack up against traditional gas and diesel trucks? For this comparison, I'm going to be comparing it to the Ford F-150 as well as their heavy-duty F-350. Price-wise, you can see the starting price of the Cybertruck is comparable to the Ford F-350. Trucks in these markets vary across a very broad range, starting in the $30,000 range, going up to well in excess of $70,000. Looking at the performance specs, the faster Cybertruck is really in a league of its own here. The Ford F-150 has a 0 to 60 time of about 6 seconds. Ford doesn't really release specific numbers, just because that's not really a focus of these trucks. Trucks are really focused on power, torque, and hauling and towing things. And in this department, the Cybertruck is no slouch. If the power and torque numbers by Motor Trend are accurate, the Cybertruck almost doubles the numbers by the traditional ICE trucks. On the payload side, the Cybertruck is in slight excess of the best F-150, and it actually falls into the range of the F-350. It's probably about an F-250 for comparison. On the towing end, it's a similar story, although it does tend towards the F-150 in towing capacity. Ground clearance is much, much greater on the Cybertruck. In fact, Elon said that the Cybertruck will have the greatest ground clearance of any production truck. So this is a Cybertruck, but where's the bed? A truck has to have a bed, right? Yeah, well, it's kind of hidden behind this sliding cover at the back. They call it the vault. And while we're talking about vaults, why don't I tell you about how you can manage your passwords in... I'm just kidding. This isn't a sponsored video. We're not sponsored by anything but likes, comments, and subscriptions here. So this is the Tesla truck. What do you think about it? Let me know in the comments down below. I'm Josh, and this is Nikola Garage. I'll see you in the next one. But there was one more thing. At the very end of the presentation, out rolls a Tesla ATV. The driver got off the ATV, opened up the bed of the truck, and pulled out an integrated loading ramp before proceeding to drive up into the bed of the truck and plugging the ATV into either a 110 or 220 outlet in the back of the truck. Not only was this a brand new vehicle we've never seen from Tesla, but it also demonstrated an important feature of the truck, and that was the ability to lower the rear end of the truck for loading. This is possible because of an adaptive air suspension system on the truck. Trucks today still use old-fashioned things like leaf springs, which have been around since the days of horse-drawn carriages. So this adaptive air suspension system gives the truck a lot of abilities that it would otherwise not have, such as the ability to vary its ride characteristics between the road or off-road. And that is a really neat feature of this truck that seems to be a little bit underlooked at this point in time. If you really want to check this thing out, head over to tesla.com/cybertruck. And you can see all the details there and find out how to pre-order the thing. That's it.